Happy May the 4th, and today, since it is a very special nerdy Star Wars day, I thought I would ask Ian a bunch of randomly, or as this thing puts, the 25 toughest Star Wars trivia questions in any galaxy.
No, I'm scared.
Because he is probably the biggest Star Wars nerd I know.
Yeah.
Like, it's just ridiculously stuff that you don't need to know about knows kind of situation.
I have a map.
So, I figured this would be really entertaining to see how much he actually does know about Star Wars and test his knowledge. So, the first one on this website, and this is a GameSpot website, the first one is, what are Luke's aunt and uncle's job on Tatooine?
Moisture farmers.
Which is correct, moisture farmers. I don't probably know half of these because I'm not as big of a nerd as he.
So?
In how many languages is 3CPO fluent?
3CPO?
Did I say it? Yeah.
It's C3PO.
I know who it is. I'm just, yeah. Okay, what? Just ask the question.
6 million.
Yes. What is, don't mock me, what is a Wookiee's homeworld and how do you pronounce it?
Kashyyyk.
Yes, very correct.
What?
This one's a stupid question.
Is it?
Who actually shot first?
Okay, so, for the record, this is gonna be a trick question because they always do that. But it's Han. Han shot first.
Okay. Yes. It does say that in the 1997 special edition, the scene was edited so it appeared that Greedo shot first.
The only reason I allow that edit is because it made Han appear more badass, but still, he shot first.
Okay. It says, alright, let's dig a little deeper. Which character is partially named after George Lucas' son?
Crap. George Lucas' son's name is Jet. I'm gonna go on a loop and just say Plo Koon, because I don't remember.
It is Daxter Jetser.
Oh! The cafe shop owner! I forgot he was a character!
He creeped me out. I'm sorry.
Because he's that big dude with four arms. He's like, hey, Obi-Wan, what's up?
So he's very drunk?
No, he just sounds drunk.
In which movie does the camera pan back up after the crawl?
Episode 2, Attack of the Clones.
How many dewbacks were in the original 1977 theatrical cut of the first Star Wars movie?
One. There should have only been one.
Two!
Damn it!
Five more were added in the 1997 special edition. Which species stole the plans to the Death Star?
Bothans.
Bothans is correct.
Many Bothans died to give us these plans. They used that in episode 4 and in episode 6. No more stuff. Well, technically, if you think about it in new movie terms, it no longer counts. But the only time it's ever referenced in the movies is in episode 6 for the second Death Star. But continue. I'll shut up.
It's okay, I know you're such a nerd. What was the original name of the first Star Wars movie when it went into production?
Blue Harvest. That's its production name. Or its name to be given so people wouldn't know, even though technically the original name was just A New Hope.
Incorrect.
What?
Adventures of Luke Starkiller, as taken from the Journal of Willis, Saga 1, Star Wars. Which bounty hunter in the Empire, I don't know what I was saying. Which bounty hunter in The Empire Strikes Back is wearing an old costume from a Doctor Who episode?
I think it's, there's Bossk, there's Boba Fett. It starts with a D, and it's the dude with the mummy, who's, like, his face is wrapped up. But I can't remember his name for the life of me right now.
It was Bossk.
Bossk? What?
Look up Doctor Who episode The Tenth Planet to see the pilot in an identical getup.
Hold on. Never mind.
Okay. Who kissed Leia first, Han or Luke?
Luke. because Leia kissed Luke in the beginning of episode 5 when he had gotten saved from being frozen out in the tundra. Han saved him. Because he didn't kiss her until they were on the Millennium Falcon later on when they left Hoth. So the answer should be Luke.
Correct.
Yeah.
And it says technically she kissed him.
Yeah!
What does AT-AT stand for?
All-Terrain Armored Transport, otherwise known as the Empire's Camelback.
Correct. What odds does C-3PO give Han for successfully navigating the asteroid field?
Why? This question always comes up. 620,000.
This is a very specific number. Is that your final answer?
The odds of successfully navigating an asteroid field are... I don't know, I'm hearing 620,000, I'm hearing 720,000. It's something in the 100,000s, I know that much, but it's... 3,720.
Correct.
Yeah!
How did you do that?
Okay, so how I did it is I was like, I'm thinking 100,000 because I'm thinking, no, the odds successfully I'm getting asteroid field are 720,001. I'm like, no, that doesn't seem that big. So I was like, what is it? And I just kind of like imagined the scene and played it in my head like 4 times and I was like, wait, the 720 is there, but there's something before it's a 3.
It's 3,720 to 1. You're ridiculous.
I have to do something.
Who is I can never say his last name.
Calrissian.
It's not gonna happen.
Lando Carr.
Co-pilot in episode, was that 4? Return of the Jedi?
That's episode 6.
6.
And his co-pilot is Nien Dum.
That's right, that is a 6. My bad. Nien Dum is correct.
Everybody started to like his species after episode 6. Even though
what is the name of Boba Fett's ship?
The Slave One!
Yes, this is correct.
Or Slav One, depending on how you want to pronounce it.
Slav.
They wanted to pronounce it Slav instead of Slave because Slave is bad, but...
Slave Leia.
I know.
It's in the movie.
I know.
Okay. Trust me. Who was the original commander of the Death Star?
The original commander of the Death Star should be Grand Moff Tarkin.
Correct.
Yeah. Because he oversaw the construction and he blew the fuck up on the first one.
What is the largest annual pod race in the world? And who was Anakin Skywalker's chief rival in it?
Bunta Eve is the name of the pod race. Anakin's rival is Sybil. No. Yeah. No. Yeah, Sebulba.
Correct.
Because I was thinking of, Road to El Dorado when I said Sebulba.
No, you were right. What day is Wookiee Life Day, and where did we first learn about the holiday?
Wookiee Life Day is... around Christmas time, because we first learned about Wookiee Life Day in the Star Wars Christmas special, the very much so movie that has been pushed away into the minds of others because nobody wants to think about it. So I'm gonna say Wookiee Life Day is December 22nd.
I didn't know there was a Star Wars Christmas special.
Exactly.
Incorrect.
Fuck.
November 17th.
I was close.
You were in the holiday season, yes. Darth Vader's chest piece has some writing on it. What language is it in, and what does it translate to?
It's in Arubesh, because every language that exists in Star Wars is Arubesh, but I almost want to say it says Sith. I've never even noticed that he has words on his chest. So I must be stupid and say it says Vader.
Incorrect. Both are incorrect.
What? It's not Arubesh?
It's ancient Hebrew. It translates... to his deed will not be forgiven until he merits.
I didn't even know there was something written there, so there's that.
The Imperial probe droid was also known by another name. What is it?
Floating eyeball.
Dude, bro. Zelda joke, I'm sorry.
I don't know. It was the Imperial Probe. That's all everybody ever called it, was the Probe Droid. Probe Droid or Eyeball. I'm going with one of those two.
It's called the Probot.
What? The Probot!
Probot.
That's Probot. Stupid.
Which is the first original theatrical movie where we actually see Jabba the Hutt?
The official original first movie we saw Jabba the Hutt was episode 6. Because he was added into episode 4 with CGI later on.
Correct.
Where? This is so out of place in that movie.
Where was Luke Skywalker originally headed to pick up power converters?
Where? Anchorhead.
Specifically? Is Anchorhead like an entire...
Anchorhead's the entire city.
Specifically?
I don't know, because I only remember him saying Anchorhead.
Tosh Station?
Tosh.
Tosh. Tosh.
Toshi. Toshi Station.
Do you remember now?
Yeah.
Who is the only Rebel pilot to survive all three movies in the original trilogy?
Wedge Antilles.
Yes.
Because he has an entire book series, he has games. I like Wedge. Wedge is one of my favorite characters. What am I talking about? Everybody's my favorite character. What just fell?
This is true. It's pretty. The new Star Wars movie is coming out in December. I don't know. Oh, this thing was created November 16th. 2015, by the way. So
this was this last year.
The 7th.
It was last year's movie, so it was episode 7.
Yeah. The new Star Wars movie is coming out in December. In what month are all 6 original Star Wars films released?
The original 6 have all been released in May.
Correct. Which is the same month as George Lucas's birthday.
Yep, that's why. That's why Star Wars Day is May the 4th.
And the final question, which should be the hardest question, but if he's as big as a nerd as I know he is, then he should get this right very easily.
I have a song.
What species is Yoda?
Ah! That's a trick question, because they've never revealed the name of his species before.
Correct!
Yeah!
Since nobody knows, or maybe we should say, knows no one does. Yeah. So that's the GameSpot quiz on Star Wars junk that's nerdy. The toughest Star Wars questions, which to him didn't seem very tough unless you asked the very deep trivia in the movie.
Yeah, I know more about the lore, the expanding universe, and stuff like that. I don't really know a lot about movie technicality, because as much as I love the movies, I didn't delve that into them, because I like the kind of wonder and mystery that was what the movies were.
That's it! You've conquered the Star Wars questions.
I'm a nerd!
You've gotten the mass majority of them right. I didn't keep count. I'll probably figure something out about that later. Anyway, point being is, my husband's a giant nerd.
Yeah!
But that's okay. So, that's about it. We'll leave it there. And are you happy with yourself? I'll take that as a yes. But thank you guys for watching, and happy May the 4th, and hope you will enjoy the rest of your day. The only problem about today is we're both kind of Sith people.
Sup?
So May the 4th is like, eh. We'll enjoy tomorrow a lot more.
Even though it's Cinco de Mayo.
Cinco de Mayo?
Cinco de Mayo!
Anyway.
Quinto de Mayo!
You guys have a good day. Bye!